Hi, this is the Derivatives 2 tutorial, and I'm just going to work out a faster and easier way to do the derivatives, but at first I'll support them with the definition of derivative, then I'll explain the general rules behind it, and then we'll do some examples, and you'll notice that it's much quicker than before. So we're going to start off, I'm just going to label it as function types, so that way you don't get lost. Do a little wavy line. And then we'll also have maybe a definition of derivatives. And that should be fairly simple since we've done that in the last tutorial. So the first one is, I'm going to have a different way of writing it, so you just have to pay attention. But the derivative of a constant, which C is constant, and basically we're just going to break this down in the definition way, and then we'll revert back to it later on. The biggest thing is that I'm going to just write out the definition first. As h goes to 0, f a plus h plus, or oops, minus f of a all over h. That equals, what's f of a plus h? That's just going to be the same constant. So it's just going to be a constant minus the same constant over h, which it doesn't matter, that's going to be 0. And then you have the next kind of type, and that's going to be d over dx to the x. Now, I'm not getting into functions like with arithmetic or anything like that. I'm just doing the basic, like, you look at one digit and you can figure out what to do. So the derivative of x, let's just do the limit. Let's do the definition again. A plus h minus f of a over h, right? What's the definition of that? Well, f of a plus h. Well, let's just say f of a, that just means x, right? So that would be x plus h minus x. Because we have to remember that whenever you see this function right here, that just means y equals x. And we want to know what y prime is equal to. So, x plus h minus x all over h. Well, the x's cancel each other out. You get h over h, which is equal to 1. Let's go on to a different one. Let's go on to the one we did before. Find out how much easier it is. In a minute, that is. X squared. Do what we did before, right? Only a little bit more complicated, because we're going to leave it in general form. F of a all over h. Now, we have to plug in. Remember, f of a plus h, that whole quantity is squared. So, should be exactly this, x plus h, that whole quantity squared, minus x squared, all over h. Well, if you work out the arithmetic, you'll see that it is x squared plus 2xh plus h squared minus x squared all over h. Now you can pull out an h from there, and you can cross out these two x's, x squared that is, So now, you'll have a 2x plus h. Now remember, that's still limit as h goes to 0. Well, 2x plus h as h goes to 0, that's just 2x. So the result is 2x. Let me square all my answers here. Make sure that we're doing good deeds. So, what's the general rules? Do a little squiggly. D over dx of a constant, that equals 0. Just need to straight up memorize that. You'll cause yourself much more headache trying to derive it every time. Just remember that due to the derivative of a constant, it's a rule. The derivative of a constant equals 0. We just proved it with a definition of a derivative, but you don't want to have to do that every single time. So, derivative of a constant equals 0. That's any constant. Then, d over dx of, let's just keep it in general form, x to the n power. Now I'm going to give you the solution, then we'll figure out why it is. It's n x n minus 1. Now that's called the power rule in a lot of textbooks. And, you know, the power rule is actually a general term that's used in engineering and physics, and I mean, you'll see that all over the place, but it's based back into this very concept of calculus. So, and all you can see is that essentially what happened is the exponent in the initial term was subtracted by 1, and it was tossed over here. So you can see that n was put up front, and it was subtracted by 1 when it was after the derivative was complete. The best way to learn a lot of this stuff is by doing examples, so I suggest that you go to the example section, and I can kind of just show you a good list of examples, and they're pretty simple. You'll get it real quick, and you'll like it a lot better than the definition of derivatives, which is just a pain and a novelty thing for most people that explore calculus. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one.